Okay, now in another skillet, you want to turn the skillet on medium heat, and you want to take 2 tablespoons of butter, put it in the skillet. Now I'm cooking rice. So you want to take your 2 tablespoons of butter, and a large skillet, combine the mix, making rice and roni. Some of you know how to make it, some of you don't. So you want to take your large skillet and put the rice in it with the butter. And first what you want to do is you want to brown, you want to saute the rice, golden brown. So it's good to have one of these. Turn this over a little bit. The chicken's still cooking. It actually takes about 10 minutes on each side, because sometimes you could try 6 minutes and might not be cooked all the way, so it's good to do like 10 minutes on each side. That way you know it's thoroughly cooked. And take the butter, move it around the skillet. The rice turns brown. Actually, you want to have it on low. Saute over medium heat until the pasta is golden brown, stirring frequently. And after you do that, then you want to add the water and the seasoning packet. And at the same time, you want to have your meat cooking.
Let's see. This is what the finished product of the chicken looks like. Golden brown.
Actually, you have to turn the skillet so that you can actually see rice being cooked right now. Chicken is about done. Oh, the chicken is well done. Actually, it's too done. I'm going to turn this off, because that was in there too long. Keep stirring this rice around so it's brown. And with the butter in there, it won't be sticking to the skillet. That was the timer for the chicken. See the color of the rice? It's getting brown. And this is called sauteing the rice. to make sure it's evenly over the skillet so that it's all turning brown. Might want to have a fork for the chicken or some tongs. I just want to have this on medium heat. And make sure it's not sticking to the sides. Okay, can you tell that it's brown now? Gotta keep on mixing it up so that it all gets its even course. Oh, there's the brown coming out. Okay, now's a good time to start pouring in the other part, which would be stirring in the water in the seasoning packet. Take the scissors out. This normally would be a good way to have the seasoning go to the bottom. Then you want to add your 2 cups of water. The line's probably going to go off in a minute. If it doesn't, that would be a surprise, because this alarm is like so sensitive. But every time you see it has smoke coming up, okay, now you want to cover, reduce heat to lower. Actually, you want to bring to a boil, then you want to season, then you want to cover it. So, probably in like, you can set the timer for like 10 minutes. That's when you'll see all the bubbles arising. And then that'll be when you cover it with the top on low for 17 to 22 minutes. So now what you want to do is you can start your hot water for your corn. So you want to set the oven, or the stove rather, on medium heat also. And you want to cut open the corn. It's very simple. You can get it from Ralph's. Corn tops. Just open the package. You want to put enough water in the pot to cover the corn. I'm using 4 of them, so I'll put 4 in here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Put the rest in the refrigerator, because I'll be putting that later on. Butter away. Now you can see the butter is slowly moving up. The water is slowly boiling. Actually less than